Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. 各位来宾，大家好，欢迎你哋参加今日纪念仙桥和华裔军人嘅献花仪式。 Welcome to the Chinatown Community Remembrance Day Ceremony in honor of the Chinese pioneers and Canada's wartime sacrifices. Before we start, we wish to recognize and thank our bagpiper, Mr. Dave Wilson. We will now begin our program with the singing of O Canada. 等大家肅立。
Thank you very much, Mr. Robert Chang, for the leading of the singing of our national anthem. Next, we'd like to invite Mr. George Ng to offer a prayer of remembrance.
Are getting larger every year. On this day, we should be thankful for the rights and freedoms that we have as Canadians. And this is largely due to our veterans who fought for Canada in the various wars and often at a great cost. Today, we stand under this monument. And what you see here is a Chinese railway worker and a Chinese Canadian soldier. Railroad worker commemorates those Chinese who built the railroad for CBR and linked BC to Canada, which was a condition for BC to join Canada. In this respect, they were nation builders, and it was the cost of great lives. It is said that there was four lives, Chinese lives, lost for every mile of railroad built. The soldier, of course, is a tribute to the Chinese Canadians who fought for Canada in World War II. They volunteered when they were not Canadian citizens and did not have Canadian rights. And yet they went to war, fought in all the theaters, joined the Army, Navy, and Air Force, fought with distinction and honor. And when they came back, they fought for the franchise. And that was achieved in May 1947. So Chinese Canadians then became Canadian citizens with full rights. For this, we are forever grateful, and we will not forget that. Today, to all veterans, particularly to those here present, thank you. We will remember you. And I will close now with a quote from Rudyard Kipling. Lord God of hosts, lest we forget, lest we forget.
November 11th, Remembrance Day commemorates Canada's wartime sacrifices. This year is the 75th anniversary of the defense of Hong Kong. 2,000 Canadian troops arrived in Hong Kong on November 16, 1941. Against overwhelming odds, these troops display courage defending Hong Kong and suffer one of the highest casualty rates of any Canadian theater of action in World War II. At this time, we will introduce our special guests who are here today. The Honorable Haji Sajjan, Minister of Defense. Madame Liu Fei, the Consul General for the People's Republic of China in Vancouver. Ms. Jenny Kwan, sorry, I don't have you on the list. Member of Parliament for Vancouver East. The Honorable Suzanne Anton, Minister of Justice. Yes, and I'm going to go do this in random order, I'm sorry, because this is not in any order at all. Okay, so now, yes, Mr. Don Davey, I don't have you on the list, but okay, this is Mr. Don Davey from Vancouver Kingsway, Member of Parliament. Okay, now I'm just going to read from my list here, okay, and I have to apologize, it's not in order. Okay. All right, I have a list here now. Oh, no. So this is the list for the reef, I'm sorry, okay? MLA for Vancouver Kingston. Ms. Mark Melanie, MLA Vancouver Mount Pleasant. Oh, I do have Mr. Don Davey on the list now here, but okay. Next, we have Mr. John Yap, MLA for Richmond. Mr. Shane Simpson, MLA for Vancouver Hastings. Mr. Richard Lee for Burnaby North, MLA for Burnaby North. And Mr. John Yap, Richmond, I've already introduced. I'm sorry? I also have a couple other counselors here. Miss Adrian Rammer, City Councilor for the City of Vancouver. Miss Adrian Carr, Councilor for the City of Vancouver. We have Ms. Erin Trump, for the Vancouver Parks and Recreation. Have I missed anybody? Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, there is Ms. Sarah Kirby Young. You didn't sign in, okay? Chair of the Parks and Recreation. Mr. Hubert Yu, the President of the Chinese Vietnam Association of Vancouver, to deliver a commemorative message for the early Chinese pioneers. 現在有請中華會館理事長廖崇英先生致辭。
尊敬的加拿大三级政府代表，尊敬的中华人民共和国驻温哥华总领馆刘飞大使。 尊敬的加拿大华裔退伍军人，尊敬的华人社区的领袖们、女士们、先生们，我们在和平纪念日的今天，聚集在华埠的劳工纪念碑前，缅怀加拿大先烈，缅怀华裔军人，缅怀华工移民先人，铭记他们为加拿大的和平、保卫世界的和平、牺牲自我的奉献的精神，有着特别的意义。若其死者思其树，引其留者怀其源。我们华裔移民今天能够生活在自由、平等、多元文化的加拿大的社区，要深情感恩，饮水思源，要感谢我们华裔军人在一战和二战的期间，在加拿大当局对华人实施歧视政策，华人没有投票权，并且要支付不合理的人头税。在这种情况下，华裔军人能够自愿的参军入伍，为加拿大、为抗击法西斯和日寇、为保卫世界和平热血奋战，终于在1949年为加拿大华人赢得了我们的公民的投票权。让我们向加拿大的军人致敬，谢谢大家。今年是加拿大军队参军保卫香港抵抗日寇75周年，大约有2000名的加拿大士兵，包括我们的华人军人，前赴香港参加壮烈的抗击日寇的保卫战，有近半数的加拿大军士兵牺牲了生命或者是负伤。我们加拿大和中国，包括香港人，永远会怀念加拿大军人在抗日战争中做出的历史的贡献。早在1856年，华人就有移民到 BC 省。1877年，大批的华工参与修建横跨加拿大东西两岸的太平洋铁路。今天，旅加的华侨华人已经有150万多，成为加拿大第一的少数民族。我们中文也成为加拿大第三大的语言。华人广泛地参与了加拿大多元社会的发展，受到加拿大社会的认可。明年是我们加拿大建国150周年，也是华工参与修建太平洋铁路竣工的130周年的纪念。加拿大的华人和全加拿大的族裔会和谐共进，为建设加拿大美好的社区、保卫世界和平共同努力奋斗。谢谢大家。Through their courage and sacrifice, these men and women have helped to ensure that we live in a freedom and peace, while fostering freedom and peace around the world. This year marks the 75th anniversary of the Battle of Hong Kong. Canadian soldiers first saw actions in World War II defending Hong Kong against Japanese attack in 1941. These soldiers had limited military training, but they fought for the encourage of seasoned veterans. With virtually no chance of victory, they refused to surrender until they were overrun by the enemy. Almost 2,000 Canadian soldiers went to Hong Kong, when more than half of them were either killed or wounded. Those captured by the Japanese endured tortures and starvation. Remembrance Day marks the official end of the World War I on November 11, 1918. The first Chinese arrived in British Columbia before 1800. Unlike other immigrants, they were not allowed to vote and they have to pay a tax. about 200 Chinese volunteers for the Canadian Army in World War I after the war ended. Returning Chinese veterans continue to face racial intolerance and unemployment. The 1923 Immigration Act, also known as the Chinese Exclusion Act, kept all the Chinese from entering Canada. At the start of World War II, more Chinese volunteered for the Canadian Army. Government policy did not allow them to join the Air Force and the Navy. But the policy was overturned as they were considered useful in the war in the Pacific. They fought on land, sea, and air. Many lost their lives. The Chinese Exclusion Act was finally repealed in 1947. After the war was over, Chinese were finally allowed to vote in 1949. We thank the Chinese Canadian veterans, for volunteering to fight for a country that did not want them, and for their sacrifice to pave the way for us to be full-fledged citizens of this country. The Chinese Canadian community, now more than 1.5 million people, continues to make enormous contribution to Canadian and to enrich the social fabric of this great country. Thank you.
和思慧，我发现后园的荒地上也生出来一朵橙红的罂粟花，摇摇摆摆在秋风秋雨中。这一朵罂粟花。 让我想到加拿大十元钞票背面的图画，老兵、少女和男红，竖立在国殇日的纪念碑前，女兵手持望远镜在瞭望，一双白鸽展翅飞翔，和平的使者，我们绝不会。 轻视占为人的国土，我们的军人不是为了战争，我们有比自卫更崇高的使命。我们维护世界和平。我们自豪地球上这一片最辽阔的国土，从大西洋到太平洋，一条铁路把东西两岸连接起来。 无数铁路华工的艰苦和牺牲，促成了加拿大的统一。这一朵罂粟花让我想到，每年国殇日纪念会中，老兵们重新穿起军装，金钱佩戴了勋章，年纪老迈却精神抖擞。第二次世界大战时期。 华裔青年踊跃志愿参军，由于他们的英勇和牺牲，使到华裔获得了公民权。这一朵罂粟花让我想到，每年国殇日纪念会中，各族裔的男童女童穿起军装，后继足前行的步伐。
一对接一对大踏步敲过，让我们卷越加拿大灿烂的未来。Thank
you very much, Evelyn and Tiffany. 再来，我哋系要朗读英文先。
By Lieutenant Colonel John McRae. In Flanders fields, the poppies blow. Between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks still brave and singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you, from failing hands, we throw the torch. be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
Shall not grow old. Speed that our left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn them. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
Pleasant duty to conduct a wreath laying ceremony portion of this service. Because this is a service to commemorate the veterans, they will be given precedence in the laying of wreaths. As I call your name, please have the representative come forward and lay the wreaths accordingly. On behalf of the Army, Navy, and Air Force veterans in Canada, specifically the 280, I call upon President Kelly Kwong and George A. to lay the wreath for the veterans. We have a wreath from Her Majesty's Canadian ship Discovery. Our representatives from the Navy here. If not, I will ask the cadets to lay the wreath on their behalf. Cadets. Please send to the Discovery down here. Thank you very much. Stand easy. We now go to the official wreaths. Representing Canada, on behalf of a grateful nation, the Honorable Harjit Singh Jan, Minister of National Defense, Member of Parliament, Vancouver South. People's Republic of China, Consul General, Her Excellency Liu Feng. representing the province of British Columbia and his own constituency riding of Richmond Stevenson, Honorable John Yap, member of the Legislative Assembly, Richmond Stevenson. Other counselors present. Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, Hong Kong Economic and Trade Office Principal Consultant, Catherine Yun. On behalf of the 42nd Parliament of Canada, Honorable Hedy Fry, Member of Parliament, Vancouver Centre, representing Hedy Fry.